What made you want to make this record, Edge?
Well,
it's just to say, just about to say something nice about Shirley.
I think U2 has two instincts. One is to experiment and try to discover what's outside of ourselves. And the other instinct is to be very much ourselves. When those instincts are equal and opposite, we seem to do our best work.
Till the songs have all arrived before we decide on the name of the album. This time round, it was a very clear thought. You know, and I just saw tonight, just looking over Lake Michigan, there was a moment when the sea and the sky became the same color, and you disappear into infinity, no end in sight. And that's seems like just a really positive thought.
The bass part on Magnificent is really up there with the greatest ever bass parts. And
it plays to my strengths for us to work in a situation where we are jamming material.
We played some amazing spots over the years. We played on top of the public toilets in Sheriff Street.
Van that we brought the gear down in was robbed, but they brought it back afterwards. And they, thanks lads, we just needed it for a job.
It's the guy who robbed the van.
You know a little too much about this.
A little known fact about Red Rocks, when we got there, there wasn't anyone there because it was raining and it was a cloud had descended and the promoter had cancelled the show. But we'd only made, I think, about $3,000 at that point, but we'd invested it in filming the show. So we told the promoter, we're playing the show whether nobody comes or not. As you remember, there was, you know, hardly anyone there, but we had this fantastic thing which saved us. It's called the wide-angle lens. It's an astonishing thing to have an album that may last forever.
Some people learn how to create art in a particular way. You know, when I play, I just take it all out in the kit.
It's because we know each other so well, it's like we can finish each other's sentences.